As a farmer, I'm used to using sunlight to grow things and to energize people by creating delicious and nutritious food. So there's something pretty cool about having all of the energy that we need to be able to run and all the electrical needs on the farm just created right here in the same place as we're still growing crops.
Hi, my name is Ashish Kapoor.
And I'm Teddy Pitsiokos.
And we are at the Agrivoltaics project at PEC's community farm at Roundabout Meadows. So what is Agrivoltaics? Agrivoltaics is both the production of solar energy and the production of some sort of agricultural product on the same tract of land. And that can be grazing, sheep or cattle, and that can be crops. This right here is the first crop-based agrivoltaics project in Virginia. So the way this system works is relatively simple. You have south-facing panels, they generate energy. That energy first goes to the battery, charges up the battery, the rest of it goes to the farm and supplies energy for our electric functions. When we need more energy, that's pulled automatically from the battery and we're able to create a self-sustaining system.
One of the great things about having a setup like this is that it creates energy security for you. So with this battery backup, we know that if the grid goes down or if there's a disruption in service, that we'll continue to have our energy. On top of that, it reduces our energy costs because we're currently getting about 99% of our electrical use covered by these panels, even on a cloudy day.
So in places like Virginia, where our utility bills are expected to double, you're now insulated from that impact of those escalating bills. So as those bills continue to rise, you're locked in, you're saving more and more money over time.
On this quarter acre of the community farm, we're generating all of the electricity we need for running our farm operations, as well as growing crops. So we're growing both in ground and in raised beds for sites that don't have good agricultural soil to work with, if you think of an urban farming site or a parking lot site.
And one of the things we'll be doing on this project is not just collecting the data, but sharing it. Agrivoltaics is very particular to the climate, the region, the soil type. So the more of these projects we get in Virginia, the more differing results we'll get in different regions. We see agrivoltaics projects like this as a solution to three big problems. One, rising electric demand from data centers. Two, increasing pressures on rural and agricultural lands. And three, the need to shift to renewable energy.
So all across Virginia, all across America, we are constantly faced with choices about what we're going to do with land. Are we going to develop it? Are we going to continue it in a more natural state? Are we going to use it for farming and food production? How are we going to include infrastructure like energy infrastructure on that land? Many times those are sort of positioned as false choices of one or the other. And what we're working hard to do here is demonstrate that maybe you can combine several different goals. In this case, climate and moving towards a clean energy economy by using solar in a way that is compatible with continuing food production while enhancing the health of the soils and restoring biodiversity to a larger parcel. But in a future where the increase in power demand from data centers is as much as 300% what we produce today, we need every solution to be on the table. So the solution to enabling more people to participate, from homeowners, farmers, school systems, retail store owners that have large parking lots, places where you could generate energy and become part of a much more reliant grid, we need to change the regulatory structure and the incentives so that that's a favorite outcome.
The agrivoltaic system here at Roundabout Meadows produces just under 20 kilowatts of electricity. There are about 40,000 farms in Virginia, each averaging about 190 acres. If you multiply that 20 kilowatts across 40,000 farms, or even a percentage of the 40,000 farms, you'd be producing a significant amount of electrical generation. How much production would depend on each farm's needs and the willingness to participate.
If we expanded it a little bit to a megawatt, maybe 5 acres worth, 10 acres worth, then you're talking about significant contribution to the long-term energy needs of the state of Virginia.
Even if only 25% of the farms participated at that level, there'd be up to 10,000 megawatts or 10 gigawatts of generation, with a scale and a design that everyone is comfortable with, keeping farmland in production. We want the state and electric utilities to increase the incentives and reduce the barriers to projects like this, so it's easier for farmers who are interested in showing up their energy security and reducing their electrical bills to also be part of producing electricity for the rest of the state. That win-win solution could take us a long way towards a better clean energy future for Virginia.
So a project like this invites a lot of exciting opportunities. One, the policy at the local level and the state level, what can we do to facilitate more of these projects? But by placing this project on a farm, you're also bringing in new spaces and new energies. So someone that might be interested in the solar side of things may come and check out the project, and they may start to learn about agriculture and say, this is pretty cool. This is a whole science and an art in of itself. On the flip side, a farmer may come out to see the project, and they may start to look at solar energy in a different way. Rather than as a threat to their livelihood, it may awaken new opportunities for a different relationship with solar energy.
I often think about the future of farming and its sustainability in a rapidly changing world where there's constantly pressure on agricultural land and farmers are looking for new solutions to have their farms be economically viable.
This project is small, it's local, and it works because what we try to do is have honest conversations both with farming and with solar and find a solution that was a compromise and really put it in the ground and show it to folks so they can inspire conversation, policy, and replication.
This is a project we're really excited about. We hope to have as many people out here to see it as possible and continue to share our results.